ISUPK.
Hey, salam, man. It's Priest Kevin Gondonhall with the ISUPK. And the commander Johnny Ayala in California, man. Telling all blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians, subscribe to this channel, man. You want true salvation? You're going to learn from the priests and prophets of the ISUPK, man. Subscribe to that channel. Hit that button, man. And it's there with that. Salam.
We want no cowards in our camp, in our camp.
Universal practical knowledge started out of 1 West 125th Street out of Harlem, New York, under Commanding General Yahana, man. We come out here to teach the truth according to the Bible, man. The same Bible that's in your mama's church, the same Bible that you have, the same Bible that you got on the app on your phone. We teach the truth according to that Bible. And guess what? The truth according to the Bible, the book that everybody claims to be an expert in, the book that everybody claims to follow, well, guess what? Clearly, we've been lied to, because the truth, according to the Bible, is that blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans are the children of God, man. The people that America oppresses and destroys in this place are the children of God. We are the real Jews, according to the Bible, man. Don't let no white man say he's the real Jew. The Bible calls any white man that says they're a Jew, or anybody that's not black, Hispanic, or Native American that's claiming to be a Jew, they are the synagogue of Satan. Because God has said we are the special people on the earth. We are his children, and it's right here in the Bible. It's in the Bible, but we've never been taught this. You know why? Because the people who we run to teach us the Bible, the people that we run to teach us the truth about God, are liars. They are absolute liars. And that's why we call the white man the devil, according to the Bible. Because the word devil means deceiver. And the white man is the biggest deceiver on the face of the earth. The white man painted the greatest man to ever walk the face of the earth as a white boy. Christ is a black man. The Jews are black. The prophets are black. Everybody in this Bible are black, according to the Bible, man. According to these scriptures. Give me Deuteronomy 7 and 6. Let me explain something to you, man. The Bible has the blueprint for black problems. The Bible has the blueprint to our oppression in America. We've been marching for 50 years, for 60 years, man, for 70 years. And guess what? Another 10 years, if we don't come back to this book, we'll be doing the same thing. Our children will do the same thing we've been doing. Marching does not change our problems. Voting doesn't change our problems. Protesting doesn't change our problems in America, man. Do you know we are special? And because we're the Lord's children, we're special. There is a certain way we have to do things. But first, let me prove to you that first, you're special, man. Black man, you're special according to God. Hispanic man, you're special according to God. Native American Indian man, you are special according to God. Read that.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 7, verse 6. For thou art an holy people.
For thou art a what?
An holy people.
The word holy means separate, man. The word holy, when you translate it to the Hebrew, which it was written in, it means separate. The God of the Bible is saying blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans are a separate people. That shouldn't be hard to believe. We the only ones that suffer in America the way we do. We are separate when it comes to suffering. The captain just brought out, black people are number one in AIDS. number one in diabetes, number one in heart conditions, number one in the coronavirus, number one in child molestation, number one in rape. We are number one in everything negative, man. And we're separate. We're separate in the negative things. Everybody loves black culture and black music. Everybody want to be around black people when it's fun. But when it's time for black people to go through black people problems, we separate. We by our goddamn selves. Well, guess what? That's not my words. The Bible says we're separate, man. In the good and the bad. And right here, we're going to read about the good, black man, Hispanic man, Native American, Indian man. This is God's words. Read what the Lord said.
For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God. The Lord thy God hath chosen thee to be a special people.
The Bible says the Lord thy God has chosen thee to be a special people, man. Meanwhile, we in the streets talking about Black Lives Matter. We begging these animals for our lives to matter. But guess what? Not only do Black Lives Matter, not only do Hispanic and Native American Indian lives matter, guess what? According to God, according to the Bible, our lives are special. Our lives are better than every other life on the face of the earth. For all you All Lives Matter folks out there, guess what? The Bible says Black Lives Matter. Before, Black Lives Matter wasn't even an organization, man. And let me tell you something. Black Lives Matter is not the solution to fixing our problems. Let me tell you something about Black Lives Matter. That organization is misusing and taking advantage of black people's desire for justice. Black Lives Matter is taking advantage of the love black people have for each other and us seeking justice in America. Guess what? Black Lives Matter was protesting since 2012. Y'all remember what happened in 2012? Trayvon Martin was killed in 2012. And that's when we first seen Black Lives Matter. And how many Trayvon Martins have we had since 2012? How many of our young black boys have been slain in the streets by these racist devil police officers since 2012? It keeps happening. You know why? Because Black Lives Matter is not the solution, man. The Bible says we are holy people. Special, man. Keep reading.
God will come. A special. And what the brother said about Black Lives Matter, what he's saying is that the solution is that you are all right in your anger and your oppression. When black people gather together to say Black Lives Matter, you are just reacting to a long pain and suffering and sorrow that we go through on a daily basis of discrimination and murder and unlawful murder, man. Unrighteous murder and killing amongst our people, man. But the solution should not should be more than marching in the streets. You know why? Because when we march in the streets, there's no big change. But altogether, when we boycott something, or if we boycott, it's more successful, man. If we start now not buying from certain industries and certain buying from America and supporting certain channels and industries and companies who are against us, then they will see. Then they'll wake up. If we together as a people say, you know what? We cannot work as normal until our issue is solved with us being killed and that's not receiving justice in the court system, then it will truly change. But us protesting and screaming Black Lives Matter, we gotta do a little more than that. We gotta do a little more than that. That's what the brother means. Go ahead.
Y'all give that powerful priest and prophet a hand, man. Give him a hand, man. Read where you at.
God will come. A special people unto himself, above all people.
Say it again.
Above all
people. No. You lying. This is not coming from the Bible. The Bible is not saying black people are above all people. This is not what book is this. This is the Bible, man. Guess what? This is the Bible saying this. We never were taught that the Bible is saying blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans are above every single race of people on the face of the earth. We were never taught that, man. Why? Because these Christian pastors who teach us the Bible, who teach us the lies, they work for the white man. That's why the Christian pastors are the ones who tell black people to go vote. when we've been voting for 60 years. We've been voting for 60 years, and guess what? We've still been dying for 60 years. We've still been living in poverty for 60 years, man. Voting is not the solution. Going to church is not the solution, man. Joining hands with the people who have historically always hated us is not the solution. The solution is in the Bible. But first, you must understand this. We got to understand this as a people. The Lord says we are a holy people, a special people.
A special people unto himself, above all people that are upon the face of the earth.
The Bible says blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans are above all people that are upon the face of the earth. How about that to all you All Lives Matter folks, man? The God of the Bible is saying we are better than them. And you know how you know? Look at black people in their worst conditions. Look at how we live and look at what we produce. In the ghettos, we produced LeBron James, the Beyoncés, man, the George Washington Carvers, all the greatest minds, the greatest athletes. I was watching a track video the other day of the United States Olympic women's track team. And them sisters ran and dusted every other nation on the face of the earth. And it's not because America makes them great. It's because we are the Lord's children. White people love to say black people don't contribute to America. We're lazy, we complain. If we don't like it here, we should leave. Let me tell you something, black man. The greatest deception after Christ being a white man is black people believing that we need America. That is the greatest deception after Christ being white. Black people, we don't need America. America needs us. And it has always been that way. You don't believe me? Let's go to the history. Let's go to the history. The brother brought it out earlier. Who were we sold to when we were brought to America? We didn't come to America on our own. We were put on ships in chains. They came and sought us out and got us. You know why? Because they knew in order to build such a great empire, they have to get the Lord's special children to build it for them. And America is nothing without blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. And guess what? Because America has been so arrogant into believing that they are better than us and that they don't have to acknowledge us as simply humans, God is going to destroy your empire, America. God is going to bring your nation to its knees like the whore she is. America is the whore, man. And this place has been absolutely brutal to our people. Well, guess what, black man? We don't have to beg them for our lives to matter no more. The Bible says our lives matter. Give me Leviticus 20 and 26. The Bible says blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans' lives matter. Now that we know that, what must we do first to make our lives really matter? We know we're better than them already, so now what can we do to start fixing the problems in the black community? Everybody have discussions and sit-downs and roundtable talks and debates about how we're going to fix the black community. We've been having discussions and talks for years, man. When the real solution gonna finally be brought forward? When we gonna talk about what we have to do? What we really have to do to stop these people from killing us, man? To stop these people from putting their foot on our necks in oppression? The Bible has a solution. The Bible has the blueprint. Just like America was built off of the laws in the Constitution, our nation is built off of the laws in the Bible. And without the Constitution, America will crumble. Well, guess what? When you see black people in the ghettos, when you see Hispanics in the barrios, when you see the Native Americans on the reservations, you are witnessing our nation crumble because we don't follow the blueprint that has been placed for us to rise up as a nation. You understand? Read that.
The book of Leviticus. Chapter 20, verse 26, and ye shall be holy unto me, for I the Lord am holy, and have severed you from other people.
The Bible says, and you shall be holy unto me, for I am holy. Meaning the God of the Bible is calling blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans to be separate. And I'll prove it to you. It just said it. Read it again.
And ye shall be holy unto me, for I the Lord am holy.
For I, the Lord, am holy. The God of the Bible was saying, you know, I'm separate. There's no other gods with me, man. That's in the Bible. You understand? And guess what? Just like there's only one true God, that one true God only has one set of children. And that's blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. And this is what God wants for his children. Keep reading.
Come to a come. For I am the Lord, am holy, and have severed you.
And have what?
Severed you.
Have what?
Severed you.
You know what severed means? If you were in a car accident and your arm got severed, if your leg got severed, that means your leg or your arm got cut off. It got separated from its body. Well, guess what? The God of the Bible wants blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans to be separate from America, to be separate from the deviant culture of this place, man. It was never our culture to be homosexuals. It was never in our culture, according to the Bible, to molest children, to murder brothers, to steal, to lie, to sleep with another brother's woman, man. That's American culture. And because we follow American culture, we are destroyed. The God of the Bible says we are to be severed, meaning he wants us to be separate, man. Cut off from this place. I know people wondering, how can you be in America and be separate from America? Well, guess where you're standing right now, if you're wondering that. Guess where you're standing? Chinatown.
Right.
China. My Donald Trump voice. This is Chinatown. It's China. It's nice. It got Chinese scribbles everywhere. You standing in Chinatown. It's separate from America. It's in America, but it's separate. Guess what? Let me tell you something. Black man, Hispanic man, Native American, Indian man, you don't have to go anywhere to be separate from America. You know what you do? You take your spirit out of this place. You stop getting high off the white man's drugs. You stop doing what the white man wants us to do when he puts them crates full of guns in our neighborhoods. I just watched a video with one of the grand wizards of the Ku Klux Klan admitted to saying he drives to Chicago and puts liquor and guns in the alley. And he said, we don't have to kill black people no more. We go and put a crate full of guns and liquor in the alley in their neighborhoods, and they do all the work for us. You know why that is? Because black people were not taught the truth according to the Bible. If black people knew that we were special, that we were God's children, well, maybe we would have some goddamn self-esteem. Maybe we would look at a fellow black man as Christ, as our brother, man, as something special, the way the Bible says we're special. America paints us as thugs and criminals when we're special.
And what the brother just said was so heavy. Don't let that go past, man. Like we always say, America puts drugs in the black community. What this brother just brought up is not the first time I heard it. Go on YouTube and Worldstar, pull up a video from about 2-3 years ago. There's a black man making a video talking about how all of a sudden a big crate of guns just show up in the neighborhoods or in the alleys of Chicago. And here this brother bringing out about how a grand wizard and a Ku Klux Klan,
right,
a white man, what he does is on purpose,
right,
bring a crate of guns and put it in the hood. So and then what's gonna happen? If there's a bunch of guns, us being in that hood, we want protection,
right,
and want to use it to gain money, we're gonna go and grab them guns with no question.
Right.
But the OGs, the old heads of Chicago, are a little more wise. They've been around for a little bit.
Right.
So they start seeing random crates of guns pop up out of nowhere. That's strange, right?
Right.
Ammunition just don't pop up.
Right.
That's just like money.
Right.
That's just like you walking down the street and you see a box of money. You know, like, somebody put that there.
Right. Yeah.
And you're going to ask yourself, why the hell would somebody put a box of money right here?
Right.
The same thing with them guns in Chicago. Why the hell would a Ku Klux Klan member put a crate of guns in the hood? It's so we can destroy each other, man.
Right.
The same thing with the Planned Parenthood clinics. They put it where? In the black and Latino community. Why? Because they want us to abort our children.
Right.
Our oppressors have been doing that since Egypt, man.
Right.
The Pharaoh was scared of Israelite children and wanted all the sons of the Israelites to be eaten by alligators, to die. America is at war with us. The Ku Klux Klan, the Aryan Nation, is at war with us, black man.
Right.
They put guns, crates of guns, in our neighborhoods. What we gotta do is wake up
and we got to find our defense.
That's right.
The Bible is our defense. You know why? Because it has structure. It has code. We know about the street codes. We know not to snitch. We know not to do this and not to do that in the streets. But do we know in the Bible to die for our brother, just like Christ died for us?
That's right.
Do we know to love our brother as we love ourselves? Meaning what? Meaning you gotta forgive your brother over pettiness. You know why? Because a black man is the only black, is the only person you got in America, man. All we got is each other, man.
That's right.
So little small beefs gotta be squashed. Because you know why? How the hell I'm a beef with you, but then I got a whole nother enemy beefing with both of us.
Right.
We gotta wake up and be smart.
That's right.
Go ahead.
Y'all give that power of priest and prophet a hand, man.
My whole life was trying to find something to follow. Had loyalty, every man tried to borrow. Felt pain and a lot of sorrow. Got betrayed, sold packs, I didn't even have my heart broke. Living confused, about to lose hope. Cops got me on the side of the road like a sideshow. Need an antidote before I croak. Now I'm setting fire to rhythm man blues, call this guitar smoke. Rebel with no cause, trying to find direction. The world got me vexed. Picked up a bad liquor habit that's hereditary from oppression. Felt like my life was on fire, trying to find an exit. Now look, 10 G's plus a good record. Sometimes a follower is a soldier, trying to find a good shepherd. Plus when you in hell, how do you excel? Wisdom, the breath of life, I'm believing fairy tale. Listen well to what I tell. No calling can cause pain, something that a rebel knows very well. Can't you tell I was sent from the Lord? Got a tongue like a two-edged sword. With